That was beautiful. Find the pocket.
Hey everyone, welcome back to JR Pro Shop Vids. Today we're going to take a look at some symmetric pearls. Is there a difference between all these? Find out in a minute. So today we got Jung back on the lanes. He's gonna throw the brand new Phase 4 from Storm against three of the most popular balls we see here in the shop for symmetric pearls. We have the Storm Spectre, the 900 Global Wolverine, and 900 Global Burner Pearl. So we have four sim pearls in front of me here, but what makes each of them unique? Well, each has a different core strength and cover stock strength as well. For the 900 Global balls, the cover stocks will be identified by a number. The higher that number is, the stronger that cover stock is. So the two pearl cover stocks we have on the global balls here, we have S62 pearl on the burner and S70 on the Wolverine, so a little bit stronger than the burner. So the cores in these two are a little bit different as well. We have a stronger core in the Wolverine here, so we should see a big step up in performance. This should hook a little bit earlier and a little bit more as well versus the burner pearl. On the Storm side, the Phase 4 here has a little bit of a stronger core versus the Spectre, but the Spectre has a stronger cover stock by comparison to the Phase 4. Spectre here has R3S Pearl versus the R2S Pearl that's on the Phase 4. This one's going to be a little bit stronger. So if you want to know more about the core and cover stock strengths in the Storm lineup, take a look right up here and pause it when it goes to full screen. With very few exceptions, symmetric pearls are normally going to come very shiny out of the box, and the reason for this is they're best suited for when the lane has a lot of traffic on it, and the double balls hook a little bit too early. Now, the shiny finish is going to help the ball get further down the lane and store energy for longer, so it can corner down lane and kick out some corner pins. Alright, batterings today, Jung's going to bowl on 40-foot Mercury. Now, it's got four games of league, a three-person team, so quite a bit of traffic. These lanes have transitioned quite a bit. And the other lane he's going to bowl on is 10-1 house shot. It's fresh. He's going to throw these at box finish and then maybe adjust the surface to see if he can get a better ball reaction out of it. Thank you to all the members of our community who have joined so far. If you're interested, click the join button and become a part of the JR Pro Shop community. So that's enough in here. Send it out to Jung on the lanes.
All right, we're back for another video here with Jungo. Today we're gonna compare the symmetric pearls from Storm Roto Grip and 900 Global. So we're here on Mercury. It's already been bowled on in league. Four games, three-person teams. So we got about 12 games bowled on this lane already. I think the Phase 4 is the strongest out of the symmetric pearls that I have here. So we're gonna throw this first, try and get lined up, and see how the other symmetric pearls kinda...
Baby, you give me ice and fire.
this should hook just even a little bit less than the Spectre. That was an okay shot. Missed a little bit to the right. A little weak coming back. I got the same kind of vibes as the Spectre with it. I can tell it's a weaker core though. It's flaring a bit less than the Spectre. So it should go a little bit further down lane. Be a little weaker. Oh, missed. Yeah, it's way weaker. So I missed way inside on that one. And it held its line to the pocket. The other balls would not have done that. So the burner is definitely the weakest out of the four. We just gotta throw a good one here so we can see a good comparison. Jung's slacking here on the throwbot challenge. So as you can see on that shot there, if you look really close, the ball actually hooked a little bit early because I hit my burn that I've been throwing the ball on. So that's what you're gonna typically find when you bowl a lot of games on a lane. The ball's gonna start to hook really early because of all the traffic. So because of that, you gotta start inching left, get that fresh oil. Go maybe one or two boards left here with the burner, just so we get a fair comparison. Just because the lane's starting to burn up a little and we're getting early hook. Let's go one left with the feet. It should be much cleaner and a much more better compare, much more better. Wow. All right, all I did was move my feet one board to the left, kept my eyes in the same spot, and the ball skidded a lot further down the lane. Just because we missed that head traffic, right? People shooting spares. I've been throwing a bunch of balls here already. So the oil's starting to get picked up from the front part of the lane, moved onto the back, onto the ball, etc. That's what we're seeing. So I moved one left there with the burner. You can see it was really weak, went a little too far down lane. Throw that shot again. Let's try and slow the ball speed down a little. So you can see when the tangle is late like that, the ball is hooking too late. So that ball's a little bit too weak for how far left I am. Not yet for that ball. Let's go back to the phase four. It's not on that same line. Phase four should look really good. Stronger core, right? So it's gonna hook a little earlier, a little bit more, where the burner was going too far down. All right, see how much better that reacted than the burner? It just hooks a little bit earlier, a little stronger overall. Still a symmetric pearl though, but much different reaction. So all symmetric pearls are not created equal. Shot like this, phase four is gonna be money. Strike all day with the phase four here. One more time. This goes through the pins a lot better. This is a wrap 10, took it out. Where the burner was leaving the 10, standing, right? That's how you can tell. All right, let's head over to the house shot. Let's see what we can do with these sim pearls on a fresh house pattern. Maybe have to adjust the surface a little bit. All right, about halfway through the vid here with Jungo. Sim pearl question. If you have a sim pearl in your bag, which one do you have? And if you have multiple, which one is your favorite? Right now, Wolverine's my favorite. It's a little early, a little smoother than the other symmetric pearls. And the color is really nice, super solid. So that's what I like. Let me know in the comments. All right, symmetric pearl comparison. We're over here on the house shot. Not the ideal condition to use a symmetric pearl because oftentimes these come really shiny and they're really sharp off the back end. And on house pattern, there's lots of dry bores on the outside and at the back. So the ball's gonna hook pretty violently. So let's give it a shot here. Fresh house condition. And let's see how it goes with the trusty old phase four here. Standard 19-ish at the arrows. All right, that hooked really sharp compared to over here when there's a little bit of traffic, a little bit of burn. So we're gonna have to make a little bit of move left, find the pocket. All right, last one went super high. Let's go four more. Four to the left, standing on 35 here, 21 at the arrows. Really sharp, not the ideal shape you want to see on the house condition, because the house condition gives you quite a bit of room for error and you want to maximize that, where this minimizes it. Let's take one more shot. Carrying all the pins, but really sharp, not the ideal shape. Let's throw the Wolverine one time. Wolverine's gonna be a little bit smoother, so probably a little bit better for the house pattern. So on that one, I missed a little bit to the right and I had 2-4-8-10. Just because the ball is going a little bit too far down lane before it reads the pattern. So if I was using like a phase two or something, a little matte finish, stronger ball, it would have read the dry low earlier and probably hit the head pin. So that's one of the reasons why you need to match the ball up to the condition. And a symmetric pearl on a fresh house shot Usually doesn't do that. All right, let's hit my mark this time. Okay, so for the Wolverine, it's definitely hooking too late. As you can see, it came in kind of behind the head pin there. Got lucky, got a messenger strike. But that's not really what you want to see, the ball going through the pins. We're gonna bug Barks here. Guy's lounging. So if you only have a symmetric pearl in your bag, if you only have one or two balls and you're bowling on a house condition, how do we make it work? So we're gonna add a little surface to the phase four and the Wolverine. We're gonna have it hook a little bit earlier and maybe a little bit more. Have it read that pattern a little bit better. Have it go through the pins a little better. If that's all the balls we have, then we have to make it work. Barks! Surface time. All right, so in order to try and make these balls work in the house condition where there's a little bit too sharp of a reaction, we got a couple Abralon pads here. We got 4,000 and 3,000. So these are a couple of the highest grits that you'll find at your local pro shop. It's just gonna knock the polish off. Okay, we're gonna go 4,000 on the Wolverine because it's already pretty smooth. We just wanna make it a little bit earlier. And the phase four is really sharp down lane. So we're gonna put 3,000 on that, have a hook a little earlier and hopefully a little bit more so it has a little bit more teeth in the oil. Bark's going in circular motions all around, make sure he's getting the track real good. And by USB-C rule, make sure you get the whole ball. No cheating out there, boys. All right, as you can see, this ball here, 4,000, not too much of a difference. Just a little bit of the polish got knocked off. But as you're gonna see, it's gonna make a pretty big difference down lane. All right, 3,000, you can really see the difference in the cover now. The lower the number of the Abralon, the rougher the ball's gonna be. And the lowest you'll probably find your local pro shop is 500. You don't really wanna go lower than that. Thanks, Barks. All right, we got the phase four, 3,000 grit, just by hand, pretty quick. We just wanna knock the polish off, have the ball read a little earlier, a little smoother. Give us a little bit more room for error on this house condition. All right, so let's stand in the same spot that we were striking earlier, and let's see the difference. All right, that was a pretty good shot. As you can see, it did react a little bit sooner and a little bit flatter off the spot. It wasn't as sharp. It kicked the 10 out really nice. So let's throw a couple more, and let's see how the ball reacts. I'm gonna move my eyes one to the right, see if I can get to the dry a little sooner, see how it does. Yeah, the ball's still pretty sharp, but it's much better than it was. I could use this and bowl a pretty big game on the house pattern now, just because I know if I get it to the dry, it's not gonna overreact or be too sharp, and it's much more easy to control. All right, let's move two boards to the left here and toss it. All right, now we're looking good. That was beautiful. So standing it, you do get a couple more boards to hook to just because it's gonna dig in a little harder. That ball's got 3,000 on it, just by hand, real quick. And you can really see the difference. All right, one more with the phase four here. Same line as that last shot there. Ooh, that was sweet. Missed a pinch to the right, ball hit the dry, came back, still hit the head pin, hit the pocket, got a nice swisher strike there. So that's what you wanna see when you miss on house condition, right? They're giving you some room to miss. Use it. All right, now over to the Wolverine. So this one has 4,000. It's not gonna hook as much or as early as the phase four, just because that one had 3,000 stronger core. So same spot as before we sanded it. Oh, that's so much better. It doesn't look like much, but it is. Polished down to 4,000. It's quite a bit. You won't see it too much with your naked eye, but reaction-wise, you can really tell. Just hooks that few feet sooner, which smooths it out. Much more easy to use on a house condition like this. But if you're bowling something burned up, like we did earlier, you want to keep your ball really shiny. Wasn't my best release, but got back to the pocket, carried all 10. That's what you want to see on the house condition, right? That's why you can see some really big numbers on house condition. You match up your ball, the surface, you can have some room to play with. All right, let's move a couple boards to the left, slow down the ball speed. Two to the left, we'll slow it down. Yeah, I fried a little too deep for it. Wrap a 10, ring 10. That's okay though, we can work with that. Just wanna hit the pocket, right? Okay, so in order to get that 10 out, let's move my eyes one to the right, hit the dry boards a little bit sooner. All that wall doesn't have enough legs to get back. Not bad though, they just left a 2. If that's the worst thing you're gonna leave when you miss way to the right, that's a good sign. I'm not gonna throw the Spectre or the Burner on here, just cause it's pretty redundant. They do almost the same thing as these on the house condition. Just wanted to show you what the best way to make your Symmetric pearls work on the house condition if you do have it, and if that's all you have, cause you can make it work. All right, last one with the Wolverine, send it back to the shop. Chat in the shop.
All right, we're back from the lanes. We're testing out the Symmetric pearls from the Storm brands. We got 2 Storm balls, 2 900 global balls here. And we wanted to test them out, see what they did against each other and on the proper condition and also on a fresh house condition. So we first started on Mercury, 4-1, 40 feet, but it had a session of Litebulb on it already. 6 players, 3-person teams, and we bowled 4 games each. So about 12 games bowling at one lane. And you don't know where people are bowling. Some people might use urethane, some people are playing third arrow, first arrow. You know, it's one of those patterns where you can kind of play wherever you want. So we're just going in blind. We had no idea. Took a wild guess, first shot. And I will start with the phase 4, just because I know this one's going to hook the most. It's got the strongest core. And I've thrown it already in a couple pot games, so I already kind of knew what it did. And I got myself lined up, and it looked really good. Same with the Wolverine. And then the Spectre, just a little bit less than the Wolverine overall, a little sharper. And the Burner was obviously the least amount of hook. So not all Symmetric pearls are created equal. They all have distinct shape, a distinct amount of hook. The conditions are gonna be pretty close to the same what you wanna use them on. You wanna use them on lanes that hook quite a bit. So for here, traffic on the lanes, 12 games, that's quite a bit. That's when these balls start to really look good. When the oil's fresh, you know, just oiled, just dressed, fresh back ends, these balls are gonna be too sharp. They're gonna be too hard to control, and your score is not gonna be that great. You have to be really precise. So as you can tell, like the Symmetric bowling balls, the pearls, they come pretty shiny out of the box. There's not many of them that come with a matte finish. The only one that I can really think of is the IQ Tour Pearl. Came out about a year and a half ago. That's like the only one I can think of that's sanded, the matte finish. The rest of them are polished, and you can see why. On the Mercury, when there's lots of traffic, these balls really look good because the front part of the lane is pretty dry from all the traffic, everybody laying their ball down, shooting spares, all that. You want to get over the traffic and you still need some shape down lane to carry the 10 pin, carry the corner pins. So that's why these balls come shiny, that's why they're used at the end of the day, and that's when they're designed for. So we set up a condition in which they would work and they looked absolutely great. With the Burner and the Spectre, the lanes probably need to be a little bit more dry. So maybe another 4-5 games need to be bowled on it before these 2 balls look really good. But at the time being, the phase 4 looked the best. Second was the Wolverine here. So then after the burned up Mercury pattern, we went over to a fresh house shot that we just oiled. And we threw these shiny balls and they were really sharp off the back end. Missed a little bit right, missed a little bit left. It didn't quite give me that room for error that they give you with the pattern. So you still have to match up your ball with the oil conditions in order to give yourself the maximum amount of room for error. So with that being said, in order to make one of these balls a little bit smoother, you can take the surface down. And what I mean by that is take a little Averlon 4000, 3000, you can just get from your pro shop. They're $8 to $15 depending. And you just go in a circular motion like Barker did out there, and it really smooths out the shape. It makes the hook a little bit earlier, a little bit more, and definitely smoother. So if you've got shiny balls, you're bowling house conditions, you're having a little trouble with the ball hooking a little bit too sharp, give that a try. You know, it really worked on the Wolverine and the Phase 4. It really smoothed out the reaction. We were able to get a little bit more room for error and bigger scores because of that. I just threw the Phase 4 and the Wolverine on the house shot because these are the 2 that hook the most, and a little bit of redundancy with the Spectre and the Burner on the house shot, just because the house shot makes everything look pretty close to the same. And then we did 3000 on the Phase 4, just to give it a little bit more teeth, hook a little bit more earlier, and 4000 on the Wolverine, just to knock the polish off, have a hook just a little bit smoother down lane, a little bit more controllable. And as you can see, it worked great. The reaction was a little bit different, more room for error, was able to hit the head pin way more, the pocket, and get way more strikes because of that. So if you're struggling on the house condition, you got shiny bowling balls, take it to your local pro shop, give them to dull it up, 3,000, 4,000 grit, give that a try. Thanks for watching, everyone. Don't forget my question down below. If you have a Sim Pearl, what is it? And if you have multiple, what is your favorite? Let me know down in the comments. Thanks for all the people who signed up to be a member so far. If you want to join the JR Pro Shop team, click that join button below and we'll see you in the next vid. Oh, stay tuned for rapid fire coming up right now.
Okay.